between these two players, but just a character-wise, I do have to give this to Zero Suit Samus just because of the consistent kill power that she famously does not have.
Yep. I mean, hey, we'll see if Golgi's going to find a way to get that going. I mean, you definitely got to get some really, really clever and precise setups if you want to be able to get those kills with Sheik. A lot of them are like into an up smash. Maybe you get needles into a bouncing fist or something along those lines, but it's going to be tough. No, honestly, like you said, going to have it a little easier, especially with some of the game plan that ZSS has. Those stun guns definitely help set up the boost kicks or even an up smash here and there. So we'll see.
Ooh, oh, I thought a down smash was going to come off that tech chase right there. Try to get that second forward air to get the kill. Down smash again on the ledge. Couldn't do much off of it, but did get that paralyzer. No punish. And early on, it looked like Golgi was going to be in control of this match. But again, that's the power of Zero Suit Samus. That character does not need much room to rack on a ton of damage in a short amount of time. But here comes Golgi fighting a little bit back. Oh, no.
Oh, they definitely went for a read. They're trying to call out a roll from Lights, but just was not able to find it. But wow, just charging up another forward smash is really making everything work here. We're going to see the flip kick back to stage, and all of a sudden, stage control is completely flip-flopped.
And playing on the ledge against Zero Suit Samus like that is so risky because of that massive hitbox on the flip kick. As we see, was that an up throw? What was that?
Yeah, up throw. Yeah.
Was it up throw that got the KO? Okay, but yeah. Playing on the ledge against Zero Suit Samus is just so risky because of that down B, that flip kick. That kick hitbox is just ridiculously big, bigger than it really needs to be. So yeah, you kind of have to be careful when you're on that ledge. But right now, no. Looking to take back control of stage, getting to center. And this is where we're going to see Sheik. I was going to say, this is where we're going to see Sheik struggle to kill, but just like that, commentator's curse.
Yeah, I mean, hey, it's going to happen eventually. Like, you did mention it. Like, you know, she'll get like 20, 30 hits, and all of a sudden it feels like it's only 20, 30%. But for the most part, like, Sheik does have a very, very explosive combo game. It's just a matter of staying consistent with it and finding the mix-ups you need when you want to make those kills or try to put your opponent off stage. Because she can continuously harass people for like what feels like the whole game. It's just, you know, being consistent on those kills. We saw the forward smash attempt once before. We saw him land twice. Land the second time, excuse me. But right here, man, look at all this pressure that they're putting on Lights just trying to keep them off stage. But I mean, still, just the combo hasn't stopped. It's been like 40 seconds, I swear.
It's been a 40-second combo and only got like 29% off of it. That's the funny part. But either way, despite all of that damage right now, No still with a 30 or 20 or so percent lead, looking for that one grab. I feel like No is really good back here right there. I feel like No is just whiffing so many grabs, but because Sheik's punish game is just so, I guess, mediocre, he hasn't really, or they haven't really been able to take advantage of it.
I got the reset into the forward smash, so at 107 now, gonna be trying to find a way to get that stock out of there, but no. Light's gonna find a way back to the ledge without too much hassle. I mean, not gonna lose a stock board or anything, which is really unfortunate, but that down's not gonna be enough.
Are you kidding me? And this is gonna be a punish right there. Yep, grab. I'm surprised the down throw didn't come, but really good tech chase there, but did get punished.
I think, okay, wow. they got the kill with the up special. What is it, the Vanish, I think it's what it's called. But I think the reason why they missed that Bouncing Fish is it actually ran off stage first and then threw out Bouncing Fish, rather just throw it off right from ledge. And that's why they barely missed on that. Either way, still able to get the stock. So I guess no harm, no foul, but we're getting into a final stock situation here. And that might be it. 100%, that boost kick way too strong. Remember when Sheik could kill, you know?
Hey, remember Smash 4? Remember that game?
Dude, forget that. Just bring back Sheik forward air from Melee. You know how beautiful that is? I know people didn't like it, but I loved it.
Oh, man, I don't think I'd play this game anymore. But
dude, it'd be so good. She'd be so good.
Shout-outs to No for taking that game one. Golgi played very, very well, but again, just got a lot of punishes on those whiff the grabs from No, but because, again, I keep saying it, and everybody knows this by now, Sheik just does not have a great punish game in terms of the amount of damage they can apply. They weren't really able to do much off of those whiff grabs, and I feel like that's why No just decided to just keep going for the grabs, because he knew that, or they knew that, Golgi really couldn't do much about it.
Yeah, I mean, when you have a character who can put down as much pressure, or maybe not quite as much, but pretty close to the, you know, the same pressure that she can be putting down, but you actually have damage output, you actually have, you know, pretty concise kill options, like, it's kind of just a bad time for Sheik, because Sheik thrives on being faster than the opponent by a lot. She is one of the fastest characters in the game in terms of not just speed, movement speed, but frame data as well. And CSS, maybe not frame data quite as much, maybe not normal ground speed, but like, she matches up almost entirely well and just kind of has an overall better kit. But man, the whole time I'm talking about that, Goldie out here putting down some mean damage.
Oh yeah, but you know what the thing about Zero Suit Samus is, all they need is one grab or one good neutral beat just like that, and they can bring it right back, as we see No doing there, bringing that gap to about 16%, but right now Golgi is just not really letting No get anything consistent going, keeping on that pressure. And again, you gotta watch that ledge when you're fighting against Zero Suit Samus, really good at reversing stage control with that flip kick.
Yeah, you try to go off stage once, if you're not like on top of it, that flip kick could just be landing right on top of your head. All of a sudden, you've got to use a resource that you didn't want to use, or you just don't have enough resources to get back. But so far, this has been a much more competitive game two than game one was. Percentage is still a little bit in Golgi's favor, but again, it just comes down to, can you be consistent in trying to get that stock out of there? And Lights has taken their time to just really push, you know, how long their stock's lasting, and it's almost even percentages now.
Yeah, and you're seeing, and No's actually able to take a couple more risks right now than Golgi is, because again, she doesn't really have that one move that they could really punish you with at high percentages. So right now, it's actually okay for No to take some risks, but just like that, as I say that, losing that stock to that down smash from Golgi, very good awareness right there from them to manage to land that hit.
Yeah, that was one of those moves that's a big risk. We're going to get the boost kick back to even it up, but that's what you were talking about. That was a big risk going for that down smash, because if Lights was ready for that, because we don't see down smash that often, but no. If Lights was ready, that could have just been a stock and we could see Lights still having a lead. They just threw out an option to hope for the best, and thankfully it worked out for them. But as we get into the second stocks here, damage is flying back and forth. They're both trying to get some good movement in here, trying to find those openings. And here we go, man. Goldie getting it going just a little bit, but Lights going to find a way right back to stage, getting that forward air to give them a little bit of room.
It's just crazy to me that Sheik has to do like a whole AP calculus problem just to do like 36% on you, and then Snoop Snoop can just grab you and do nothing and do like what, 50% in no time at all. But either way, Golgi looking really, really good right now. Oh no, punish on that down smash. Oh no, that bad rolling.
Okay. There was, I think, a little bit of spaghetti from both players there. I feel like both of them are just trying to get some options. And they're getting some options that they aren't exactly ready for, and so they aren't really able converting on anything. But man, this is just all over the place. The backer actually going to give stage control to Light now on the other side of PS2. Oh, okay.
The Nair to get a bit of stage control, and right now we're seeing Golgi go for those forward smashes, but good down smash into flip kick Zero Suit special. I feel like almost every stock Noah's taken has been that exact same way. And again, until Golgi shows that they know what to do about it, why not just keep going for it?
Yeah, I mean, we'll see. I mean, what happened there is that they ended up charging a down smash, and then great bouncing fish. Goldie just dropped the shield entirely. That's kind of what led to that stock being just, you know, just disappearing off the top. But 38% separating the two of them to get to the final stocks here of game two. Light is in control at the moment. Goldie's got to make something happen and quick if they want a game three. Otherwise, it's going to end here at a nice 2-0 for Light.
And playing behind as Sheik is just so hard, because again, it's just so hard for this character to make strong comebacks. And right now, Zero Suit Samus, if you're at 74%, you're pretty much in kill percentage. One good down smash or neutral B will probably end the game right now. So if Golgi has anything left in the tank, this is definitely the time to whip it out. We saw him go for that. Saw them go for that forward smash right there. Couldn't quite land it. Has to make up a 50 or so percent deficit. Doesn't have much time left either. Not looking too good for Golgi right now.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, if they get Lights finds a back air towards the ledge at all, that could probably close out the stock, because Sheik's not very heavy either. But Goldie's still out here trying to forward tilt. Gonna put Golgi off stage, but Golgi gonna find their way back, landing that forward air. Big opening. Oh, they could have waited a bit. No, that's it. No,
there was like 15 different whiffed forward smashes and grabs in that like 5-second period. I didn't know what was gonna happen, but either way, the Smash God's blessing, No, aka King Chris, right now taking that 2-0. But man, that was like a very close 2-0. That last 10 seconds of that match could have gone either way if one hit landed the opposite direction. So shout outs to both of them. And again, I know it looks like a 2-0 on the scoreboard, but that was like a, that really could have been anyone's game, anybody's set. But the rules of competition is that there could only be one winner, and today that is no. So shout outs to them for moving on. And Golgi is not someone who I want to see in that loser's bracket, because that was just a fantastic display despite taking the L right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. It is what it is. Goldie did do pretty well. It's just Lights, honestly, is one of the more consistent players that we've seen. I think on the most recent PGR, I think they got...